Hi, this is Shop Talk, and I'm Ria Tanwatko Trillo. When you talk about ice cream, you either like it or you like it a lot. And with the variety of flavors that's available in the market these days, you'd really just want to try them all. And some of the best-tasting flavors are developed by entrepreneurs who have homemade ice cream businesses. And lucky for us, we have two of them on the show. They're here to share what it takes to be in the ice cream business. And of course, we'll also be tasting the ice cream flavors that they offer. First up, we have Alexandra Rocha. She is the owner of Pinkerton Ice Cream. Sandra started concocting ice cream flavors while she was still in college. Hi, Sans. Thanks for coming on the show.
Thanks for having me, Ria.
Okay, now, you've always liked food. You say that, you know, if you're not cooking it, you're eating it.
Right? Absolutely. I love food. I'm always eating, and I have a big sweet tooth. So, hence the ice cream.
Right. And you were doing this while you were still in school. How did you have time to do that?
I would do it when I'd get home from classes. Sometimes orders would get crazy, and I wouldn't sleep, but it was so worth it, like, when you would see customers happy and satisfied.
Right. Now, you know, Pinkerton is really slowly getting well known around the metro, especially for its interesting flavors. How do you come up with these, you know, really fun combinations?
I come up with them, aside from what I think that customers would like, it's based on their suggestions. So sometimes I'll get a call from someone that wants their Reese's Pieces ice cream, and I'll do that for them, or they themselves will tweak flavors that I already have. So they might want to add some walnuts to a certain flavor or take away from something. So I customize it for them.
Okay, so it's partly you, partly what your customers want. What are your best sellers and your most unique flavors?
My best sellers include red velvet, banana Nutella, an apple pie, guava basil sorbet. Oh, it's a really long list that seems to be ever growing, but those are a few of the
right. And some of your flavors are seasonal, right? Depending on what ingredients are available that time of year.
Yes, like right now there's avocado condensed milk ice cream, since avocados are in season right now. So I have that as a flavor of the month.
Okay, that sounds really good. I love avocados with condensed milk. Okay, now this business has been running, as we said, since you were out of school. And it's still pretty much you churning the ice cream and doing all the work, right?
Yes, I now have someone else to help me, but it used to be all me. So from separating egg yolks to whisking to everything. So I realized that I couldn't handle it all on my own with the crazy orders, so I got someone else on board to help me out in the kitchen.
Okay, right. But it's still, yeah, obviously
it's still
you
just
supervising
us, yes.
And doing all of that. And I noticed that you have this really cute logo, which you didn't have at the very beginning.
Yep.
Tell us how that developed and, you know, what kind of look you wanted the whole business to have.
Okay, it actually started first with the tin cans and just my handwriting on it. So it was very artisanal, really just straight from my kitchen. The logo came about, a friend actually designed it for me. And I told him that I wanted something classic. I wanted it to be very old-fashioned, you know, and classic, something that looks really artisanal. So he came up with this logo for me, and I loved it right away.
Right, exactly. I think when I saw it, I thought it really suited, you know, like what you're doing and the flavors you have. Now, did you ever think or prepare for maybe like how popular Pinkerton has become?
I wasn't really doing it to, it started as a hobby. So it just slowly started progressing, and I'm happy that it did go that way, because a lot of restaurants were approaching me even while I was in school, and I couldn't supply them just yet. So I guess I was somewhat prepared. I knew what to expect when I was done, and I had to put more effort and focus into expanding it.
Right. And you're saying at the very beginning you couldn't meet demands because you only had like a small machine, so you had to get a bigger one and all of this and all of that. How much money did you have to put out, or what you know, machines did you have to invest in to really get this going?
I started with the small machines because my sister had bought me one and several like dessert books, because I was obsessed with frozen yogurt. So she got me the ice cream books and frozen yogurt books, and I brought it back to Manila and I started playing around in my kitchen. And from there, that's how I started coming up with the different flavors.
Right, right. And now, how many hours a day do you spend making ice cream?
Oh, a lot. Sometimes all day, sometimes, but with the help in the kitchen, it's a lot better. So I'm able to at least sleep now before
you
I would
have a
stay
life.
Up. And yeah, when I started with the small ice cream makers, when it slowly was expanding and I had to supply restaurants, I had to reinvest because I started with 7,000 actually only that I borrowed from my parents for ingredients and packaging. And then from there, I saved up and I made that rollover. And then I reinvested into the bigger equipment.
Right. So if people want to order now, they go to the website and they can order online.
Yes.
And you deliver and they pick up as well?
It's a pickup point. So I'm working on more pickup points now, like in Makati and Alabang. Because okay. I understand it's hard for them to always get it from San Juan.
True. And you're available in restaurants. Which restaurants
yes,
are those?
It's available in Cafe 1771 in El Pueblo. In Seconds, in that's in Fort Bonifacio. Empire Deli, which is in McKinley Hills, and Dali, which is around here. It's in Quezon City.
Right.
Very
okay.
nearby.
And you have, do you have to like go out and market Pinkerton ice cream, or it's mostly people calling you?
A lot of it is word of mouth, which to me is a big compliment because, you know, people don't lie and they want to share something they enjoy with other
True.
People. So it's mostly that, aside from flyers or, you know, Facebook or people tweeting about it, things like that.
That's great. Good for you.
Thank you.
Makes life easier. Okay, now we're getting to the part of like the interview that I really like, which is, of course, trying the flavors, right? So you have a lot of them here. I'll try a couple, starting with the banana Nutella. That's like one of your best sellers,
It is
right?
one of my best sellers.
Okay, well, everybody loves banana and everybody loves Nutella. All right, so this is melting just right. Mmm.
So like it's fresh bananas, there's no artificial flavoring, mm-hmm. and I don't skimp. That's one thing that we believe in, no skimping.
Yeah, because that will really like make a difference when,
exactly.
when you make something. I like it, because that one's not too sweet.
Exactly.
It's just right. And is it hard to like get, you know, like the creamy ingredients?
No, it's not. It's just actually finding the right texture and consistency for you, so that's, you know,
so
that's when you figure out your recipe with
it's
the cream, milk.
All right, this one is maple bacon, which
yes.
I think is fascinating.
It tastes
I
like breakfast. Really
I love it.
I always tell people, try it on top of a Belgian waffle.
Yes.
So, yeah.
Perfect. And there's real bacon bits, isn't
mm-hmm.
it?
It's real bacon bits.
Wow, and ice cream. That's crazy.
Yep, and I like how it's sweet, and then you have the salty, which contrasts it. So it's
yeah,
kind
my,
of balanced.
My favorite thing. Exactly, because when I have waffles, I always have them with bacon and like maple syrup.
Maple syrup, so there you go. It's just one scoop on your waffles or pancakes.
That is crazy. That is crazy. Okay, this one is a sorbet, right?
Yes, this is a guava basil sorbet, and
okay,
it's very refreshing. It's a good palate cleanser. A lot of people actually order it for when they have formal dinners at home, and they have it in between meals.
Nice, very refreshing. I like it. How many other sorbet flavors do you have?
I have two. I have, I need to expand with that one, but guava basil, mango basil, and I have sangria sorbets. So I have a white
oh.
sangria and a red sangria.
That sounds like fun. Okay,
that's what they
more.
Serve at Dali, since it's a Spanish restaurant.
Ah, okay. All right, and then this one here, maybe you could pass me
oh,
that
sure.
one, the
this
red
one
velvet.
Is the red velvet.
Okay, awesome.
And that one is a popular flavor because, of course, everyone is into red velvet these days. And there are always
right.
lines in front of cupcake shops and cake shops. So I was like, why not make it an ice cream?
That's nice. The kids would like this one.
Exactly.
Right? Because it has like little cake bits and it looks really nice and pink. And
exactly.
I love it. It's
Thank
a good
you.
Day on Shop Talk. That's all I can say. All right. And looking forward, you know, it's like we're coming into the sort of festive holiday months.
Mm-hmm.
What are your plans for that?
I'll definitely be coming up with holiday flavors, perhaps even for Halloween, like, you know, some pumpkin pie ice cream. And for the holiday season, probably more eggnog ice cream. Last year, I had a lot of that, like Christmas spice. So I'll be playing around with those holiday flavors.
Right, lots for us to look forward to. And what's the lead time people need if they want to order from you? Because I know you don't stock up, right,
mm-hmm.
more or less.
Exactly, it's really made to order.
Mm-hmm.
So I usually request about 2 or 3 days lead time. But if they're lucky, I'm able to rush an order if the list isn't too long.
Okay, and aside from that, it doesn't just come in these small containers. You have the bigger ones too, right?
Yes, actually, these containers, I make them only for bulk orders, like for parties that people order a certain amount. But I sell normally in pints, quarts, and half-gallon sizes.
Okay, so how much are each of those?
A pint of a plain flavor is 255, and then for a quart is 510, and 1,020 for a half-gallon. And then for a mixed flavor, which would be the red velvet or banana Nutella.
The stuff with, like, the chunks?
Exactly, the chunks and mix-ins. That goes for 305 a pint, and then it doubles with the size increase. So,
right.
610 and...
Right, and aside from the fact that it is gaining popularity, what are perhaps the biggest compliments you've received from customers when they've tried your ice cream?
I love when they say their kids loved it, as long as they say their entire family loved it, because it's like, you know, you're bringing people together and you're making them smile. So that's pretty much it, that they love that there's no skimping and they can feel the difference, because I don't incorporate a lot of air into the ice cream. So they can, you know, they can tell the quality and... I don't skimp.
I agree. I do like a rich, not so airy ice cream, and I love the chunky stuff, and it's
thank
great.
You.
I love it. All right, Sandra, thank you so much for coming on.
Thanks
Shop
so
Talks.
Much for having
great
me.
Great having you. Okay, well, next up we have Fog City Creamery. More ice cream coming up after this short break. Shop Talk will be right back.